In 2022, Canva launched a simple way to create stylish, responsive sites using Canva. Fast forward to 2025, and we've just had a really significant upgrade to that tool. And in this video, I'm going to give you an objective look at how Canva websites work today, including the new update that's just been announced, plus the pros, the cons, and how they might fit into your creative toolkit. So let's get into it. Like most things in Canva, websites are actually super easy to get started with. You can build one from scratch using Canva elements you're already used to, or start with one of the literally tens of thousands of templates in the Canva assets or templates library. Plus, of course, you can easily ensure brand consistency by using your Canva brand kit. You can swap in assets from Canva's extensive libraries, and you can even add animations so that you can easily bring the content to life a little more with motion. Now, until recently, Canva websites were scrolling one-page sites only. The pages in the design were really just different sections of that single scrolling page, and the navigation menu at the top just jumped you down the page to different sections. But now, thanks to the updates announced at Canva Create 2025 just a week or so ago, you can build multi-page websites in Canva. So a single page within a website design in Canva can now be comprised of as many different sections as you'd like, and you can then add multiple pages. So the optional nav menu now links to separate pages, not just sections on a single page. But Canva still made it super simple to link to a section within a page too, so that's really handy for longer single page designs if you want those kind of internal jumps on that page. And once you're happy with your site design and the content, you can still publish a website on Canva for free, even if you don't have a paid plan. You can also customize the favicon and the search preview text before you hit publish. Now, just as a note, currently users on a free account can publish up to 5 websites which use a Canva subdomain. So for example, yourname.my.canva.site. If you want to purchase and connect a custom domain or use your own, that's possible, but only on a Canva Pro or Teams account. Canva websites are also mobile responsive by default, which is a big help, and it happens automatically. But I will talk later about where I think that falls short. Canva websites have loads of potential. There are so many creative ways that you could use them in your business. For example, you could create landing pages to promote a new product or an upcoming event, create portfolios to showcase your work or designs. You could create lookbooks for fashion collections or even for real estate listings. They're great for media kits if you're a content creator, or for just a very simple service or basic business info site. Plus, because you can do password protected sites, you could create staff hubs or members only content. I especially think they are a great cost-effective solution for longer sales pages for your launches. In fact, I've even designed Canva templates specifically for that. Plus, they can work brilliantly as simple lead capture pages to grow your email list. I've got a full tutorial on that, and I'll link to that up here, but that also has its limitations. Really though, it's that mix of speed, simplicity, and design flexibility that makes them such a handy addition to your toolkit, especially if you already use Canva. But you know I like to be real with you, and there are some definite downsides or limitations. So we need to look at the pros and the cons of Canva websites. Before we do that, if you want to use Canva like a pro, you don't need another hack. You need a system. And that's the missing piece for so many people. And it's exactly why I created Canva OS, which is my course that shows you how to organize your Canva space, speed up your workflow, and design stylish, on-brand content even if you're not a designer. And I'm excited to announce that the next enrollment opens in May. You can just go to the link that's on the screen right now or in the description below the video to join the waitlist and to be the first to know when the early bird pricing goes live. Now, let's get back to spilling the tea on Canva websites, shall we? The first limitation of Canva websites is that there is no built-in checkout at all. You can create a beautiful sales page, but if you want to sell something, you'll need to link out to a third-party checkout platform. And it's pretty simple, but most of those won't let you add multiple items to a cart, for example. So If you're looking for full e-commerce functionality to sell multiple products, Canva isn't really going to get you there. Secondly, when it comes to lead capture, it requires embedding a form on your page to gather email addresses. And currently, Canva doesn't have its own form builder. So you'll need to embed something like Google Forms, Typeform, or my personal favorite, Tally. But although forms are super easy to embed, your options are severely limited. And I think at the very least, Canva should allow you to embed forms from the big email service providers like Kit or Flowdesk. But at the moment, it doesn't. Next, when it comes to SEO, it's a little basic. You can set a title, a description, and of course the favicon, but there are no advanced SEO tools or settings at all. And you can't inject code anywhere on the site. There is also no blogging functionality. So sure, within the new multi-page feature, you could create a separate page for each blog post, and you could link them all from a central index page. But that's more of a workaround than a proper blogging system. You also have limited control over layout, especially on mobile. Now, because Canva handles the mobile format automatically, which can be really helpful, you can't fine-tune anything. And sometimes it looks great, other times not so much. It spaces things automatically and it works, but it's not great aesthetically. Oh, and one more thing. You also can't export the code or move your site. So if you ever want to move to something like Squarespace or WordPress, it's not an option. You're locked into Canva hosting for your Canva website. You can link to your Canva site from other platforms or anywhere else, but you can't integrate your Canva site into any other platform, which is not ideal for future growth. The multi-page update of Canva websites is a big win. It makes Canva websites just far more flexible and usable for different things than before. They are still great for simple, creative websites, especially if you're comfortable with Canva. But if you're ultimately going to want a more complex site or something to grow and scale with you over time, you're probably going to outgrow Canva websites pretty quickly. That said, if you love the Canva ecosystem and you just want a quick way to publish a few beautiful branded pages, Canva websites are a great option, especially, as I said, for launches, landing pages, and portfolios that you can put up really quickly and can look great. Canva websites are definitely not a replacement for something like Squarespace, but they do give you a fast, flexible way to create an online presence without leaving Canva or needing to learn another tool. If you have tried Canva's website builder, please drop a comment and let me know what you think and what you use it for. And if you've come up with any clever or unexpected ways to make use of it, please share those too so other people can see what's possible. And of course, if you want more tutorials on Canva's latest features, please don't forget to like and subscribe so that you don't miss anything that's coming next. That's it for today, folks. Have a wonderful week, and please take care of yourself and be kind to others.